Hello, my name is Gunja Walton, and I'm the manager of the Econometric Modeling Group at SAS Econometrics. In this presentation, I'm very excited to introduce to you three new procedures that were released in SAS Econometrics in VIA 4. These are Prague Frontier, which is a procedure for stochastic frontier analysis and is based on the frontier action set. Prague SMC is used for particle filter and estimation of nonlinear, non-Gaussian state space models. It is based on the SMC action set. And the SAS EVEA data engine, which provides a convenient way for accessing time series data from the US Bureau of Economic Analysis webpage. For the ones who are not familiar with SAS Econometrics, SAS Econometrics provides advanced econometrics tools for econometricians in business, government, and academia. It runs in VIA, SAS VIA, which means that it takes advantage of distributed computing. You can access all of its action sets through Python, R, Lua, and other programming languages. The first new procedure that I would like to introduce to you is the Frontier procedure. Prague Frontier helps you conduct efficiency analysis using the stochastic frontier approach. You can estimate production or cost efficiency in Prague Frontier by fitting stochastic frontier production or cost model. This is popularly known as stochastic frontier analysis. Stochastic frontier analysis can be applied to any problem where the observed outcome deviates from the potential outcome in one direction. That is, the observed outcome is either less or more than the potential outcome. There are two reasons for a producer to end up being beneath an estimated production frontier or above an estimated cost frontier. These are technical inefficiency, which always causes the suboptimal production levels, and environmental effects, which are random, and these can be favorable or unfavorable environmental effects. A production of a good is described by the equation for Y star. This is the maximum attainable output produced by a firm available given available vector of inputs X. F and parameter vector beta characterize the production technology. V is an IID error term distributed as normal. The equation for Y shows how the observed output is modeled to allow for the inefficiency we observe from data. We include U, which is the technical inefficiency term. Here, U is non-negative IID. This can be exponential, truncated normal, or half normal. Of course, the log linear transformation of this equation is used. The cost is modeled similarly, except the inefficiency term enters into the equation with a positive rather than a negative sign. Let me introduce to you Prague Frontier with an empirical application. I will consider the productivity analysis of dairy farming. I'm interested in explaining the amount of milk production based on the inputs, labor hours, feed, number of cows, and the size of the farm. The data are from the US Department of Agriculture's 1985 Farm Cost and Return Survey. Stochastic frontier analysis helps you answer these questions, these types of questions. In this brief example, I will try to answer some of these questions. To understand if a stochastic frontier analysis is the right one for this application, you can first analyze the OLS residuals. From the histogram here, there is some evidence of a negative skewness. The summary statistics reveals -0.738 for the skewness parameter. Note that you can test for the significance of this skewness statistics The return for that, I'm sorry, the result for that test, which is not included in this slide, shows that the skewness is actually statistically significant. So the distribution of the residuals skews to the left. So this is consistent with the production frontier specification. Here is how you estimate a stochastic frontier production model with the inefficiency term specified as half normal. The model fit summary shows some information about the model and the optimization process. The estimation converged after 16 iterations, and the gradient for each parameter is small enough, that is close to zero, to justify the convergence. From the parameter estimates table, you can see that the output elasticity of kettle is 75%, which is the largest among the inputs. The elasticities of the three variable inputs add up close to one, indicating a constant returns to scale production technology. Let's look at the technical efficiency analysis. First, the gamma parameter estimate in the variance statistics table indicates that 90% of the total variation is attributable to the technical inefficiency. PROC Frontier provides you two types of technical efficiency measures, TE1 and TE2. The summary for the technical inefficiency shows that, on average, dairy farmers achieve 77% of the maximum potential output in their production. Note that the maximum efficiency index is 1 by construction. There is at least one farmer operates on the frontier. The least efficient farmer achieves only 44% of his or her maximum achievable output. The histogram for TE1 shows how this technical efficiency index is distributed for these farmers. Another new procedure that came out in SAS Econometrics is PROC SMC, which I am very excited to introduce. The sequential Monte Carlo or SMC method has been widely applied in economics, finance, science, and engineering. Many real-world data analysis tasks involve estimating unknown quantities from some given observation. In most of these applications, prior knowledge about the phenomenon that we are modeling are available. Using this knowledge, you can formulate Bayesian models to obtain posterior distribution of the unknown quantities and do inference on these quantities. Often, observations arrive sequentially in time, and you may be interested in performing inference online. For example, estimating the volatility of financial instrument using stock market data. There have been many methods offered in this setting, like Kalman filter or the HMM filter, but they rely on strong assumptions like normality and linearity. However, the real data can be very complex, involving elements of non-Gaussianity, high dimensionality, and non-linearity. Sequential Monte Carlo methods offer a great deal of flexibility and provide a convenient and attractive approach to computing posterior distributions for your analysis. Sequential Monte Carlo methods provide simulation-based approximate solutions to the state space model, or SSM, which is also known as the hidden Markov model, especially for the nonlinear and non-Gaussian SSM. The SSM consists of a discrete time process, x sub t, y sub t, and z sub t. X sub t is an unobserved Markov process and are called the state variables. Conditional on x, the observable process y sub t is a sequence of independent random variables and are called the dependent variables. In many cases, the SSM also has independent variables, z sub t. These are exogenous variables determined outside of the SSM. In general, the SSM can be expressed in three distribution functions: initial distribution function, transition distribution function, measurement distribution function. Specifying your model in PROC-SMC is not hard. Let's look at an illustration of how you can define an autoregressive stochastic volatility or ARSV model and estimate the parameters by using the particle Markov chain Monte Carlo or PMCMC method. The ARSV model is given by these two equations. The parameters of the model are phi, gamma squared, and beta squared. For illustration purposes, the data are generated based on these model specifications and the parameter values 0.9 for phi, 0.4 for gamma, and 1 for beta. After specifying the prior distributions for the parameters, in this case, phi is distributed uniformly and gamma squared and beta squared are inverse gamma, you can estimate this model using PROC-SMC as given here. Here are the posterior samples of gamma squared, beta squared, and phi. The red lines here are their corresponding true values. Remember that we generated the data. Therefore, we know the true values. The posterior distributions are centered around their corresponding true values. This shows the accuracy of the estimation of this model. You can obtain the smoothing and forecasting process by specifying the smooth and forecast statements. This is the plot of the smoothing median estimate and the actual values of X. The actual values of X are in red. The smoothing median is in blue. The shadow band indicates the range between the 2.5th and 97.5th percentiles of the smoothing estimates. PROC-SMC also has a scoring functionality. You can save the model information and the learning results to a CAS data table from one run of PROC-SMC and then use this data table as input to do forecasting or other inference in another run without re-estimating the whole model. This becomes handy if you have a large data set and estimating takes long. You can fit complicated models in PROC-SMC. For example, you can estimate the effective reproduction number of COVID-19 cases using the stochastic susceptible infected or SSIR model. This example applies this model using the cases in Pennsylvania reported by the Center of Systems Science and Engineering at Johns Hopkins University. The effective reproduction number represented by R sub E is intended to be an indicator of the contagiousness of the infectious disease. The solid Y equals 1 line is the reference line. An outbreak is expected to continue when R sub E is above this line, and it is expected to end when it is below it. You can see that at the early stages, effective reproduction number was somehow under control, thanks to the strict measures taken. But later in the year, the volatility is more. So looser policies or maybe school opening can be factors in this. Last but not least, I'd like to talk about the SAS-EBA. SAS-EBA is an interface engine that enables you to retrieve time series data from the U.S. Bureau of Economic Analysis, or BEA. This website offers access to economic statistics data at the industry, regional, national, and international levels. Currently, these are the supported BEA data sets. However, all the data sets will be supported. To retrieve data by using the SAS-EBA engine, You only need to provide some common options like working directory, username, and password, and some specific options related to the data of interest, like the names of the datasets, time range, and the output table and format. These statements, for example here, enable you to access the VEA National Income and Product Account Table, T10101. There are more features on the way in SAS Econometrics. Just to name a few, machine learning and deep learning methods will be available in SAS Econometrics to do policy or causal analysis. Automatic model selection for the models in proxy special reg, and highly demanded market attribution models for marketing and advertising analysis. You can find more information about SAS Econometrics, including the documentations for the procedures that I introduced to you in this presentation at this webpage.